Welcome to another VFX Study Fairlight tutorial, and today we will learn how you can take a basic sound effect, in this case a sequence of footsteps, and process it all the way to make it fully match and integrate and feel natural in your movie scene. So Gavin Lucas is with me once again. He is the Fairlight teacher on vfxstudy.com who has built a massive Fairlight training course. Check it out. But today he will share his tricks, how he uses first elastic wave to do some synchronization. Then he will customize the sound effect to make it less repetitious, and then finally he will integrate it in the scene. He will use some automation techniques, he will use fader automation, he will use some pitch correction, everything to make the scene feel natural. So some great sound editing and sound design principles coming up. I immediately hand over to Gavin. Let me just say thanks to Audiio for supporting this video, and let's dive in.
In another video, I have already shown you how to synchronize audio events with other audio or video events in your timeline. And now I want to show you a more advanced example, and I hope this will encourage you to try using sound design and film scoring by yourself using the tools offered in Fairlight. So in this case, I have already placed a suitable audio file here beneath my video clip. Again, I have found this audio file in the Fairlight Sound Library. In another YouTube tutorial, I showed you how you can download and install the sound library. So if you don't know about that, just take a look at this video. So this time I have already selected an audio file, and this clip here has some recorded footsteps here on dirty ground. So I want to try to fit this audio clip to my video. Let's first take a look. So this time it's really more complex. We have a recording with several sounds here inside the recording. Of course, the most obvious thing would be to split up my recording here in different parts, but there is a more elegant way to do this. So to start with, I'm going to the Fairlight page. I will search for the first visible footstep here. As the foot hits the ground, let's take this picture for that, and let's align the first sound to that. Let's see if that helps. So maybe I can get away with that. But already the next footstep isn't at the correct position here. It needs to be here, maybe at this position. And I would like to use this opportunity to show you some advanced editing technique we can use here in Fairlight, and it's called Elastic Wave. If I right click on that clip here, we will find that option here, Elastic Wave, and we have to turn it on. And there are two options for turning it on. One is for use with voice, and the other one is general purpose. In this case, of course, general purpose is the right option for us. And now we are in the Elastic Wave editing mode. You can see that here at the top of the clip. There's a new option, and we could leave that editing mode here by clicking on the X. But of course, I want to use it here. And now if I'm here in Elastic Wave, I can set new Elastic Wave markers here by control clicking at certain points. For example, here at this point, hit the control key, keep control pressed, and just click with the mouse at this position. And a new line will appear at this position. And now I can move this line with my mouse. Just press the left mouse button. And now I can freely stretch or shrink my audio here to align audio events to other things here in my video. For example, to align the sound of footsteps to this second footstep here. And of course, I will go on doing that. If you have accidentally misplaced one of those aligning points, you can of course get rid of them. by hitting Ctrl and Alt, and then you can remove those lines too. This might be okay. Let's close the elastic wave editing for a moment here by hitting the close button. And then let's shrink the clip a little bit because here I have the next footstep and I want to try if I can use that clip again for that part. I will just select the clip, hit the Alt key and create a copy, and I can see with the see-through option here where my waveforms are, so I can sync it again to my footstep. If there are some more things I have to tweak, I can go to the elastic wave editing mode again to optimize the syncing. So that's one part. And as I have synced the footsteps, it's of course better than before, but to make it more realistic, I would like to use some more options Fairlight gives me here.
Gavin just used some footsteps from the Fairlight Sound library. The Fairlight library is a good place to start, but very often you need something more specific, something that fits your project a little bit better. And that's where a high quality commercial sound effects library comes in. Audiio.com is the place to look for those. They have a lot of effects that are well searchable, and in addition, of course, you find high quality music from real musicians there that you can license and use in your project. So if you want to check it out, don't forget to make use of their offer. Use the link below together with the coupon code mentioned in the description to get 70% off of your first year pro subscription. So if you need high quality sound effects and music, check it out. And now back to Gavin, who shows us how he can process those sound effects furthermore in Fairlight.
So as said, I want to optimize this a little bit more. And one thing, if you are using audio files for recreating sound that hasn't been recorded on set, it sometimes can be problematic if you're using the same audio file again and again. Let's assume our guy here is walking a lot more and I would have to use the same file several times, then the audience might recognize that there is some small loop that's always repeating. And in order to cover that, I could manipulate some of those audio events here of the footsteps. And there is a very fast way in Fairlight to separate those parts from the original clip. I can use this focus editing mode here in Fairlight, and this allows me to draw selections here inside a clip. I just have to go to the upper half of the clip, and there I will see this small bracket icon, and I can just draw a range. And now I will turn on the snapping again. I've turned it off before, and it's beneficial if I turn it on. And now I go again to this area here at the bottom half, and I just have to move this hand a little bit, click with the mouse key, and now this area is quickly separated as a new clip. And this allows me, of course, several things. For example, I could adjust the volume, or I can go to the inspector and, for example, manipulate the pitch of this event here. And if I have a lot of repeating events, it can be very good to randomly select some of them and manipulate them in their pitch, so the audience would not recognize this is just a loop playing back again and again. If you just want to manipulate the volume, you even don't have to separate your selection here. You can just use this focus mode and select one event here and just lower or increase the volume line here, and it will be automatically be separated from the rest by additional keyframes here for my audio volume. So that's a very fast way of manipulating certain audio events inside a longer clip here with this focus mode editing. Please don't forget, after using this mode, to go to your normal pointer mode again to make sure not accidentally destroying something here while moving around with the mouse. I still have the selection here. Let's get rid of that by hitting the Alt and X key. And now finally, I want to do some more optimization here. And one thing is, as the actor is going away from our camera, of course, I want the footsteps to be decreased in volume, of course. And it would be really very cumbersome to do that with the normal audio ramp here inside my clips. And there's a much better way here in Fairlight of doing this with the so-called automation. And if this is turned off, I have to turn it on first here by hit the button toggle automation. And as soon as it's turned on, you will see some new options here. And in our case, we want to automate the fader levels. So let's select the fader level for this track here. And now we see this line here. And this line represents the fader level that is set here with our channel fader. And I want the volume to start with this value here. And in order to make some kind of keyframe here, I hit the Alt key. And now I can set a control point here at this level. And now I will just move to the end of the clip here and set another control point. And this control point will be maybe set to this volume here. We can also trim this clip here. We don't need it to be that long. I will just leave the automation mode for a moment. And now let's play it back. Yeah, and as the actor is moving away from the camera, so the footsteps are getting more quiet. And of course, I could optimize it a little bit more. And this can be done with the automation in Fairlight. Of course, in our comprehensive Fairlight tutorial, we will show you a lot of more things you can do with automation and how to work with automation. But for this video, I want to leave it with that regarding the fader level. But additionally, and as a last gimmick, I want to show you how you can optimize it even a little bit more in respect of the sound design. As the footsteps are getting far away from us, I want to lower them in pitch too. And let's see how that can be done. Just for me, I will toggle the automation button off for the moment. Please recognize that the automation isn't working if I turn it off. So now the fader is fixed. But of course, I can turn it on again anytime. So it's just for me to getting a more cleaner display here. And now, as I said, I want to lower the pitch of the sound as time goes on. So we need some kind of pitch effect for our track here. And if I select the track header and I'm going to the inspector, of course, I have to make sure that there isn't any clip selected. So we really have to see the track level effects. And on track level, there is no such thing as pitch correction. So in order to have a pitch effect on track level, we need to include an effect here for our track. So let's go to the effect section. And here, let's open the search field and just type pitch. And please make sure you have audio effect selected. And there we will find this pitch effect. And we can track it here on the track header or directly to our channel strip here in the mixer. I will drag it to my track header here. That's the same result. And this will give us this pitch effect. Let's close it for the moment. And let's take a look at the mixer here. Here you will find the effects section. Please make sure that you have your effects section visible here at the mixer settings. And now we can use this pitch effect here for our track. The middle button gives us the control window again. And for example, I can pitch my audio for this track down. Or up. In our case, we want the pitch correction to change dynamically when the person is walking away. So let's move this away for the moment and let's go to the automation again. And now we want to automate this pitch effect, and we can also do that. Let's go to the automation settings for this track. And there you will also find a section called plugins. Of course, this only has options if there is a plugin on this track. And now we can go to our pitch effect and automate the semitones here. Again, I will use the Alt key to make one control point here at the beginning and one control point at the end. And I will pitch it down all the way, 12 semitones. Let's try that. And now that's even more realistic for our sound effect for this scenario here. Of course, this video was made to give you an idea about the things you can do in Fairlight. And if I want to have the very, very best results, there are of course some more things I could do, but I hope I could give you some impression of the possibilities you have in Fairlight and encourage you to use those tools Fairlight gives you for your needs regarding audio editing here inside of DaVinci Resolve.
Thanks, Gavin, for showing us these audio editing techniques in Fairlight. I think it's wonderful to see how such an everyday task like adding footsteps, how you can go all the way to integrate this and make it fit to your scene. Of course, there are a lot of things that you can do in Fairlight, and to learn them all, I highly recommend to you check out Gavin's full Fairlight course. Thanks, Gavin, again. Thanks again to Audiio for supporting this video and this entire series of Fairlight tutorials. There is one more coming up next week. Stay tuned for this. Cheers.